Myocarditis is heart inflammation, or to be more specific, it's inflammation of the heart muscle. Pericarditis is inflammation of the pericardium, or the outer lining of the heart. Myocarditis and pericarditis often occur together, hence the term myopericarditis. How often is it caused by COVID? How often is it caused by the mRNA vaccines, Pfizer and Moderna? And what are the symptoms of heart inflammation? How is it diagnosed? I'm going to unpack all of this in this video. And if you're new here, I'm Dr. Mike Hansen. Welcome to my channel, where I love to break down medical topics and provide you with real medical explanations. This is my dog, Legend. He likes balls. Myocarditis is an interesting diagnosis because it can present in a variety of ways, not just in terms of various signs and symptoms, but a variety of nonspecific labs in the blood work, nonspecific EKG findings, nonspecific echocardiogram findings, meaning ultrasound of the heart. Also, most people with this diagnosis have zero or mild symptoms. Now, on the flip side, it can rarely present with sudden cardiac arrest. And even if you are able to make the diagnosis, it's usually even trickier to determine the cause. There are lots of different things that can cause myocarditis. Heck, even heavy metal can cause it. You might also notice there that smallpox vaccine can cause it. Well, I should say could cause it, because routine vaccination of the American public against smallpox stopped in 1972 after the disease was eradicated. But the most common cause of myocarditis is a result of the immune system reacting to a viral infection. Common viral triggers include adenovirus, Coxsackie virus, influenza, parvovirus B19, and herpes. And of course, you can add COVID to that list, as well as the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. But before we get into the details of cases of myocarditis after the vaccine, let's get a baseline understanding of the seriousness of myocarditis. Disease severity can range from unnoticeable to mild symptoms to severe illness requiring ICU to death. More often than not, it's a mild, temporary issue. In more serious cases, when there's more heart inflammation, the heart has a harder time pumping blood, which can lead to heart failure. The highest risk population for myocarditis is from puberty to the age of the 30s, so it affects males more often than females. There are no specific symptoms that are associated with myocarditis, but the common symptoms include chest pain or chest pressure, shortness of breath, fatigue, swelling in the hands and feet, heart palpitations, lightheadedness, and a sudden loss of consciousness. In the early stages of viral myocarditis, patients will usually initially have fever and muscle aches. Now, if there's pericarditis to go along with that myocarditis, the most common symptom is going to be chest pain. And that's usually a sharp or a stabbing pain, but some have a dull, achy, or pressure-like chest pain. A diagnostic clue with pericarditis is that the chest pain is worse when lying flat and better when sitting up. Making the diagnosis of myocarditis depends on signs and symptoms, lab tests, including troponin levels and BNP, certain EKG findings, and echocardiogram findings. Usually, a chest x-ray will be normal, but can sometimes show an enlarged heart. Coronary angiography, meaning a heart cath or heart catheterization, is sometimes necessary to rule out coronary artery disease as a potential diagnosis. Cardiac MRI is indicated in patients with suspected myocarditis with elevated troponin levels, or if they have ventricular dysfunction, especially if they don't have a clear cause, such as ischemic heart disease, meaning coronary artery disease. Some might ultimately require a biopsy of their heart called an endomyocardial biopsy, but that's usually reserved for those who are very ill. Even though COVID is a respiratory virus, it can affect the heart in several ways. First, when COVID causes pneumonia, it can damage the lungs, decreasing the amount of oxygen that gets to the heart and making it harder for it to pump blood to the body. This is known as demand ischemia. Second, the inflammatory response from the immune system to fight that virus is sometimes excessive. The cytokine storm that you hear about, it's a cascade of cytokines and chemokines of the immune system, and that can ultimately damage organs in the body. Basically, it's collateral damage. So the damage from this inflammatory response is known to especially affect the kidneys, brain, and the heart. And that's when you have myocarditis. And as if that's not bad enough, inflammation can cause small blood clots or microthrombi to form in different blood vessels throughout the body, including in the capillaries of the heart. More than 4,000 children have suffered from multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, so MIS-C, which can cause inflammation of the heart, the lungs, the kidneys, and the brain, as well as other organs. Finally, SARS-CoV-2 can also infect the heart muscle cells themselves. A study from Washington University School of Medicine in St. Louis, it showed that the SARS-CoV-2 virus invades the heart muscle cells and interferes with contraction. Researchers there used stem cells to model the contracting heart muscle tissue. Their research showed that the viral infection, it actually destroys the muscle cells and you're left with a heart that doesn't pump blood. On a related note, when we talk about COVID long haulers, one of the common symptoms that I see from patients in my pulmonary clinic is that they have this chronic central chest pain or chest pressure, especially when taking in a deep breath. My suspicion is that there might be a small degree of persistent myopericarditis going on there, but that's hard to know one way or another. As of June 10th, about 4 million children have contracted COVID. This number represents 14% of all cases and is about 5,300 cases per 100,000 children. About 17,000 children have been hospitalized and 330 have died. COVID has been in the top 10 causes of pediatric death since the pandemic began. Now, as a comparison, 188 children died of influenza in the 2019 to 2020 season. The CDC has also reported that as of June 9th, 2,600 plus people under the age of 30 have died of COVID. There have been cases in very small studies looking at patients who developed myocarditis after getting the COVID vaccine. The CDC has received 1,200 plus preliminary reports of myocarditis and pericarditis following about 300 million total doses of the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. These preliminary reports came through the Vaccine Adverse Event Reporting System that's maintained by the CDC and the FDA. Among people 12 and older, there were 267 reports of heart inflammation after one dose of the vaccine, 827 after the second dose, and then 132 after an unknown dose. The CDC continues to recommend COVID-19 vaccination for everyone 12 years of age and older. Why? That's because for every million second dose vaccinations with either the Moderna or the Pfizer, there have been tens of myocarditis cases, but thousands of COVID-19 cases that are prevented. For males aged 12 to 17, it's estimated that for every 1 million second dose vaccinations, there are 5,700 COVID cases, 215 hospitalizations, 71 ICU admissions, and 2 deaths that are prevented, with an estimated 56 to 69 myocarditis cases. For females in that same group, aged 12 to 17, it's estimated that for every 1 million doses to complete a 2-dose series of that vaccine, you get 8,500 COVID cases, 183 hospitalizations, 38 ICU admissions, and 1 death that would be prevented, compared to 8 to 10 cases of myocarditis. And then when you look at the bracket of aged 18 to 24, those numbers look even better. Since Wednesday, there's been a joint statement from the leaders of more than a dozen health agencies and organizations, including the CDC, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American Heart Association, and more. And they're all saying that the COVID vaccines are safe and effective, and that they strongly encourage everyone 12 and older to be vaccinated against COVID-19. This is their conclusion, quote, "The conclusion is that myocarditis is an extremely rare side effect and only an exceedingly small number of people will experience it after vaccination. Importantly, for the young people who do, most cases are mild and individuals recover often on their own or with minimal treatment. In addition, we know that myocarditis and pericarditis are much more common if you get COVID-19 and the risks to the heart from COVID-19 infection can be more severe. We recommend getting vaccinated right away if you haven't yet. It's the best way to protect yourself, your loved ones, your community, and to return to a more normal lifestyle safely and quickly." That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. And if you liked it, give it a like. And if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell notification. See ya.